Welcome back.
Welcome back. We are into the grand final of the BTS Pro Series Season 8 between the side of Team SMG and, of course, Boom Esports.
Yeah, you just kind of want to hit this level 4 spike on KT. That's when you get the level 2 boars up. It feels a lot better. Well, at least level 2 boars for the ore, and it's really easy to harass out. You see SMG at least starting to find that aggression in the bot lane. Managed to get Tims out, and it's not the easiest combination. Legion Commander plus Monkey King have no way of playing around this offlane, and all they can really hope for is they get enough on Yopaj mid.
Mid lane stuns out Tims, he's been caught again. This time, the kill will go the way of Moon on the Lina. And now SMG, they've rotated. Palos, he'll be targeted. KP, he doesn't have enough mana for the roar quite yet, but they will get the old school Warcraft 3 surround down. Still Boundless Strike out. Tim's gonna try and trade KP. He does eventually go down, but it's a worthwhile trade for SMG.
He's not going farming. He's just looking to fight, playing with the Eclipse, looking to really buff up that push.
Eclipse out, KB, he's in big danger and might eventually drop, but he gets the roar in time. Can they actually finish off Yopash though? It looks like they can. Tims, Wukong's command with the jewel out from FBC onto Rogi, but it won't be enough to actually finish off the Bloodseeker. The overwhelming odds will be though. FBC, he does get perched up. Mid one, we'll move back in. Wukong's gonna expire, but it won't matter. In the end, FBZ should perhaps be safe, but no Arfu. He has so much damage with the max shadow poison out. They've got all the units they need, and Moon's there to back them up on the Lina. How do you defend? Rupture there, FBZ, he's not going to be able to go for a duel either. Rogi will just chase him down. In fact, Rogi, he might get the kill himself on the support Bloodseeker. Meanwhile, on the side, they've started another team fight. KP, he's going to drop mid one. He's in trouble. He'll try to man fight it, but eventually they do get the Lunar kill. And now the duel's out. FBZ, he will be able to get some duel victory as Yopash gets a triple kill on the Ember. They're approaching. He has a TP available, but won't commit yet, as now the pings are out. They know exactly where he is, FBZ. He's been slowed up by the boars, and now the tree cut is there. Roar out as well. Relocate is flying in, but can they actually catch him? In fact, never mind, they've got a better target. Moon, he's in this though. They don't know he's there on the Lina. Laguna out, FBZ's gonna get blown up, and it's onto Palos. They'd love a gyrocopter. They're not gonna get him though. Relocate back out from CTM. They'll leave Tims behind.
It's a tough defense to ask for. Yopash is going to really have to put in the work here.
They're going to try. Homing missile out. Eclipse, it's going to be popped from mid one. Palos, he cannot stand underneath that. He needs the back. They'll try to remnant forward. Yopash, he's onto the big carry and he does get him. FBZ, he'd love some jewel damage right now, but he might just have to settle for the kill. In fact, never mind. They are going to wait. So they'll get three kills for their trouble. SMG going way too far forward. Rogi, he might make it out, but I can't say the same for KP, who is going to get caught on the Beastmaster. Roshan, though, it's going down fast. Boom, they're slowly coming in. Roshan's still dropping, however, and now the rupture out. Rogi, he'll hold them back. He might die for this, but it'll be well worth it, as they've got the Aegis up on mid one. And if it only costs you the Bloodseeker, it's well worth. However, Jules out, they have got mid one. Disruption will save for a little bit. Mid one, he will lose his first life, and now the roar is out. KP trying to help, but they want the main carry. They want that main target, and they've got him. The big surround out. Mid one, he cannot run. They haven't got any kind of high ground objective. And that 2k net worth lead is going to be a little bit concerning as FBZ is in. He got a duel out again onto mid one. They've got the lockdown, and they've got the kill. Even more bad news for SMG. In comparison to Palos as well, who's just escalated so darn far on the gyrocopter. It'd be very hard to deal with him. Rupture out though, they've got it onto the gyro. Cooldown is there to zone them out. And can you actually capitalize off this rupture? They're gonna try now. Purge is there, but CTM, he's right behind with the mech out with the relocate. They're gonna pop everything on him, but Palos, he is not dying. And meanwhile, FBZ, he's caught moving with the jewel out. They are still trying onto Palos, and they do eventually get the kill. As CTM, he was unable to relocate him out in time. Yopash, trapped in the forest, is gonna try and run down south, but Moon is there with the light strike array. They should have enough control, but no. Remnants back the other way. Do they have the damage and control this time? Disruption out. Rogi in with the blood right, but a great slide of fist dodge. Yopash gonna try and play games. He turns around with the fake grenade. It's a bit risky, Yopash. Homing missile out, mid one. Stand back and relax. And get the end boom. They'll go for the outpost, but Moon, he's moving in again on that Lina. Light Strike Array gonna land onto Palos CTM. He has the relocate up, but he won't commit quite yet. Laguna is there, but it's not enough damage. Yapage now gonna move in. Great chains out, but there's your Eclipse now. Mid one, he's been dueled up. FBZ's got him, but it's not gonna be the dual win for FBZ, but rather for mid one. They do also find Palos. Moon, he's gonna try and run. Yapage, he'll clean up the back lines. Can they find the last piece of the puzzle? They'll get him. Moon goes down on the Lina. You don't mind him being able to hit hard, especially with that Wukong's command ability that he does have. It's Palos, gonna get purged up. Let's get a homing missile out. Mid one gonna posture. They'll try onto CTM. Eclipse is there, but the press the attack and the save is now. The jewel's out, Roji. He's gonna get blown up, but they found CTM. Buybacks will fly out from the supports as they'll try to rejoin this team fight. Boundless is out. Tibbs, he will eventually drop, and now the roar's there. They've got Palos, but no. Press the attack again, gonna purge off the stun. As long as FBZ's behind Palos, it's going to be very hard to kill him off. They are lacking the Eclipse there from mid one, so it is a fair bit of damage that's not going to be out from our Luna. Palos, again, going to be perched up. FBZ's there to heal him up, though. Just so hard to finish him off. And meanwhile, towards the north, they have found Moon. They're going to move in anyway. There's a duel out, but Moon is going to be the one to win. The duel is now Palos. He's been roared up. You haven't got to press the attack anymore. He'll try to man fight, but mid one's there. He'll man fight back, and this time he'll win it out. Buyback is out, however. Palos and Moon making their way back in, but CTM and Roji are both going to drop, and that'll be a dieback on the POS 5s. Roshan, it does still stand. Moon's gonna move in, try to force it. FBZ jumps in as well. The Aegis, it's gonna go the way of KB. He does snatch on the Beastmaster. They'll lose Moon again, however. It's a dieback on the Lina. Can they keep this fight up? Eclipse is out. It's not enough, though. Mid one, he's gone to boot. And KB, he was a hero for a second, but he might be right back down to zero, as it looks like they will surround him. Boom Esports, they've got him.
Reduce the healing output as well, coming through from the side of SMG. Just go from there.
Well, everything again being thrown out onto Palos. He's going to try with the TP, play with the BKB, but the Roar is there in time. They've got the Gyrocopter. This should be a great team fight. As FBZ, he's been locked down. Yopage, though, he's godlike. He does find Roji and apparently finds Arfu as well. Yopage is just cleaning up the supports while the rest distract, and now they can move on to KB, the Beastmaster. He's locked down. Can we get another slide of fist out? You bet your ass we can. A triple kill for Yopage. Back in onto Moon. Chains out. He'll force the BKB, but Timbs, he's been caught in the forest. He'll go down. A 2-for-3 trade. SMG going for that classic play, pushing out the other side lane and trying to force the return back. However, Moon, he has been caught by himself. Oh, that is a big loss.
The wave clear from Yopage, it's a bit slow going, but they are actually going to be able to find that top set of racks.
That they are. Pretty decent trade, but now Yapage will jump in. A little bit of a cheeky remnant back and forth. He'll go in onto Roji, refreshes. Look at the damage output. Yapage, he just cleans them all up. Moon, he's, or rather, mid one is stuck in the middle of the Wukong's command. Oh, goodness me, Yapage. He just shreds through him. As bot lane, mid one, he's the only one left. They're going to buy back on KP to try and force out Palos. The Roar is going to be there, but where's your follow-up?
So they can just run back mid, shove out a creep wave, look for the push bot, maybe go for more even as Yopage jumps in.
Yeah, Remnant's forward. KP just bought back, and he's right back to the grave. Here come the tips out, Yopage. 22-2-10 is the scoreline for our Ember. He does get another chains out onto the Bloodseeker, and it looks like Roji is going down. Another kill for the Emperors now. Jewel out. Who have they got? It's going to be Moon. He's got no buyback. And now they found mid one. Another dieback out for the side of SMG. They've got two heroes left. But it's a 2v5 scenario. And Boom Esports, they may just be able to put a lid on this game number one of the grand final.
It's two heroes to defend with your two supports. They're not going to be able to do enough. The respawns here are just a bit too long, and they might even find them.
Yeah, why the hell not? You end up finding that Shadow Demon, but it's into the fountain. Yopage, he wants all of them. Roji, be careful, sir. That's not your home anymore. Look at this. Look at this.
God.
Oh, it's the Japoi show, John. It's the Japoi show. Game one of this best of five. Boom. Esports will go for a Phantom Assassin into the PL. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Here we have an unpaused. It's a 4v5. 4v5 scenario in this best of five grand final. So I guess this is the only thing you can do to try and adapt to the current circumstances, as Tim's is going to move in now. Rochi, don't die like this, sir. Yeah, I mean, I know it's a 3v2, but it's really still a 2v2 as he will back
Tim's
off.
Back.
And Tim's is back. Off his top lane, Rochi going to be in a spot of danger. Palos going to try and chase him down. Salve is going to be cancelled off. Palos still moving forward, but Rochi, he's quite healthy. And now the tree cut as well will not allow Tim's to follow up as they will get Palos and they might even find a second kill here onto Tim's.
Really good start for SMG once more, though. Like, they're just keeping Palos down. His farm is really stalling out. PA really needs Battlefield to get going, although he'll push Rochi's spot.
Big time bring a hit. Ensure that KP does die to the boat damage, and now Afu, I don't think he's quite safe either.
It's a patience game. It's Battle Fury, it's Desolator, it's BKB. They are making moves bot though, Moon.
Big stun out, but the swap is there. Moon should be able to just leap away, as now the Rupture is going to catch FBZ, and Afu's going to sneak in from the backside, gets a double impale off, and locks them all down. They've got FBZ. Can they find the idol? First they'll go after Tim's, but it's onto the Kunkka. In fact, they might have to deal with CTM instead, but no, they want your Yopash. They want that big target. Rochi, he's trying, but he'll get caught in a torrent and will end up going down, and now Palos, he's going to show up. This could be some great comeback XP and farm if Palos can secure some more kills, as Afu now, he'll be next. A double kill out for the PA. The Roshan is going to be focused down. SMG, they are not around to try and counter this out. They're too late to the party, and now the balance is there. They're at least going to pick off Rochi. They might even find a few more as Afu. He'll be chased down. Rochi, he'll commit the buyback. Do they really want to fight this, though? KP's going to drop immediately. Crit down by Palos, and now they found mid one. But he's going to double away. He'll be fine for now. Moon leaping around the team fight. But which way are you going, sir? Tim's has found him. The Mirana, that's his last leap charge. CTM's on the case with Palos. They want that mid Mirana down, and they're gonna get it too. Moon's gone. Meanwhile, mid one, he'll try and go onto Yopash. He'll find the Kunkka, but can they escape now? Well, they're gonna keep trying to fight. FBZ's down. Palos, he'll man fight here against the PL. He needs those crits. He knows these crits, and he gets them. A rampage out for Palos. He'll clean up. Say 20 minutes ago, where Palos was level 4 against the level 8 Mirana. Still, mid Tim's, he does get caught out. KP able to pick up a nice kill for the side of SMG. But now, the idol's here. X-Torrent out. KP, he's going to avoid that, as now the jump is in with all the illusions out, the mana, the HP, but the crits are out. Afu, he just gets shredded as they're on to mid one once again on that PL. Yule's out. And this PL, I don't know if he can actually survive this. There's too much control. There's too much damage. And there's just too many numbers. As CTM, he'll just keep the tips up. KP, he's not out of danger either. Fade grenade out. Oh, it just brings you back to the MLG days, John. The grenade shots. Just fine. Of course, it's very hard to push into this PL shards. That's the one thing. SMG, they have some decent higher ground. In fact, they found FBZ with that arrow out to try to blow him up. KP swaps back Moon. Back into the base is a nice impale. Afu gonna lock down so many heroes, but they can still lose KP. Palos, he'll be ruptured up. They want to hold down that PA through the secondary life. As Tim's, Wukong's command was there. Palos, though, he's been arrowed. Great swap out from KP again, and now maybe they can move in for this fight. They will go right after CTM on that Weaver. They'll get another kill into the Kunkka. They even found Yopage. Great defense here from SMG, and that'll be a great amount of XP and gold going back the way of the Dire. Well, they are grouped up. They're going to go for a five-man smoke. Who do they run into? It's going to be right onto KP. Tim's, he's there with the BKB in time. Onto Arthur as well. Silence him up. KP's already lost his first life. But mid one, he's going to go right onto FBZ. Onto that Death Prophet of Palos. He's going to be there to help. Mid one needs to run ASAP. He's trying. Impel Arthur. He may have saved the day, but not quite. BKB's there in time. They'll keep trying to fight this one out. Arthur, he's trying to run, but it looks like he's not making it. The Torrent Storm will catch him. As you Kepage now. They may need to make their own escape. Mid one, he's looking to come back in, re-engage, try to get a good team fight, but the Torrent Storm is there, or rather just the Torrent. Kepage, he'll keep trying to fight, but mid one, he does clean up here, but Palos, he's back in now. Sun is there, mid one trying to run. Dagger, gonna get a connect, and they get him. Palos, they're trying to back. In fact, never mind, he's back in. Moon and Rogi, they'll keep posturing. CTM, he'll tank the arrow. Ethereal, no, it's not enough. CTM, we'll get the time lapse off in time. As Moon now will be chased down by our Weaver. Spirit Vessel out, Dagger in, Yule Scepter. Is it going to be enough? It doesn't seem like it. They find another.
Oh god, it looked pretty bad at first. Araji?
Well, CTM, he might go down here, and he does! Just walks a tile too far, tips her out immediately. Palos, he'll get a reset back at the fountain. Yopash, he'll take the illusion rune for himself. KB gonna move in, but only sees the Kunkka thus far. Now Dagger's out, Rogi, he'll be targeted, but Palos, he'll back off for a bit. In fact, never mind, they got the X back. That'll be a Bloodseeker gone, and KB, he'll be focused down as well. A secondary kill already for the side of Boom Esports, and there's no buybacks on either hero going down. And that should be a free Roshan, the way of Boom.
And just place himself in danger of the PA killing him off. Just a... awkward streak. Afu?
Afu's in, but Palos, he picks up the Aegis. Afu, he got stunned midway. Mid one, he's gonna try and force the fight with the DD rune, but he's already so damn low, and now the chase is on. Can they get a stun off? Not quite. He's gone invis. However, Moon has been left behind, but no, mid one, he's gonna come and re-engage once again into this team fight onto FBZ, but the damage output is way too high. He needs to back off once again. Dagger's there, Palos will blink strike in. Mid one, trying to run, Palos trying to get some cleave damage off the dagger. Still not gonna land with the doppel, it's not gonna be enough, or maybe it is. Palos is unable to keep the chase up. Just kind of abuse it with the Dagon. Of course, with the shotgun, so much amp as Afu. Nice impale out, he's caught too. CTM immediately blown up. Tims, he will try to trade with the life of KB, but KB, no, he's been X'd back. Shotgun is there to try and help him out, but it's gonna be no good. He'll die once. But can they keep this fight going? Heal illusions flying in. Torrent Storm is there, and now Afu has been caught out right from underneath the earth. He will be dragged back out by the torrents and eventually does die. Dual Scepter out, Moon. Silence is there. It won't be enough, however. Mid one. He's gonna try and manfight Palos. They'll try against the PA. But Palos, he's a tanky boy himself with all that evasion. He'll happily fight. As Afu maybe caught a second time. But no, it's gonna be FBZ. He'll get Dagon down by Moon. Arrow's there. They've locked down Palos. He's out of mana and could be in massive, massive danger. But he's got that Aegis up. Tims, he'll hang around on that Monkey King and try to help. But do they actually have enough damage to do with Palos here? With the Silver Edge they just made, as Palos, he's dropping quite fast now. He'll try to crit his way back up, but eventually the Aegis is gonna go down. Arrow gonna fly in at the perfect time as mid one. He'll go back in, but Palos, he'll survive through it. Back with the lifesteal. He pops the Satanic. Back up to full HP. Mid one, still around. Invis is there, but FBZ now. He's rejoined the team fight. Mid one needs to run ASAP. The dust is there, the shivers. It won't connect, but it won't matter. The Torrent Storm into the boat, but no, the doppel. Mid one, he's still running, but can he do it? It doesn't seem like it. He's almost there to the next doppelganger, but no, it's not quite enough. Oh, he tried so hard. He got so far, but John, in the end, it doesn't even matter. It just doesn't. There's a boundless strike is out. Moon's been caught. And eventually, he'll go down.
Content hits on Palos. We'll see if it will benefit him if he can reach that mark. Why back or you force that?
Nice rupture swap. Palos, he just gets destroyed. They just zap him to death, and now CTM's gone. BKB TP's out. However, Moon has now seen the DD. He'll take it himself. There's not enough time to save it for mid one. Jump in. Who have they got? It's going to be Palos immediately onto the bench. Torrent is going to be nice as well. Right into the boat onto two, but no. They avoid it immediately. KP, he is still alive on the bench, but eventually will drop here to FBZ. Still has the remnant to play with. Can they find more? The wraparound SMG. Gonna go the long way, trying to surprise Zarfu's in. He's got FBZ with the stun. Follow-up stun out as well with the lances. They've got enough. They'll take care of the Death Prophet. No buyback on FBZ is now. It's onto Tim's. They might have the monkey, but no, the time-lapse is gonna save the life of the Monkey King. Is now Moon. He's stuck in the Torrent Storm. He'll leap out, but the X is there from Yapash. Hold him down. Take him out, but no, the Impale Zarfu. He's back to help out. There's your Dagon Ethereal Blade mid one. He's dropping very low on the PL. He might need to escape his Palos. He'll have the damage. The buybacks are there though. They want to keep this fight going, but the side of Boom have already backed out, or have they? Dagon is there by Tim's. Rather on two Tim's. Oh, the cleave damage as well, because that doesn't really care about evasion, but oh, Palos, he's going to break the smoke there on Rogi immediately. Rupture, they've got the PA. That's the target they want. Swap out immediately, but they can't blow him up yet. The BKB is going to save as a Satanic. Heals him back up. Dagon's out. They got CTM. There's no buyback on him, but they've also found two on the side of SMG, as now they'll get rid of the KP Remnant. Zarfu will buy back. So it's going to be a 4v4 scenario. Smoon, he'll keep chipping away at Tim's. You've still got to be very wary. Palos, he's hitting so hard on this Phantom Assassin. In with the extra damage from that Nullifier. And now, that fourth Roshan of the game is going to be so valuable as Rogi will get jumped. Nullifier out. It's not going to be enough. Impels there from Zarfu as they try to blow up this PA again, but Palos is still healthy enough to survive as he has the Dagon or other Satanic, but he needs someone to hit. Meanwhile, mid one!
What?
He went in by himself. So many bucks.
Yeah, could be like two refreshes if refresh orb is about. Oh,
nice rupture swap. Arrow there as well with the Dagon out. They'll get rid of one in the form of Tim's, but now KP. He's caught out again. The Ghost Scepter, not going to help too much, as now the Tidal Wave. It'll drag back Zarfu as well as KP, and they might get a 2-for-1 deal here. As Boom Esports definitely finding some great pickoffs on the high ground of SMG. And they're going to abuse the timing of mid one being down, as they'll go for the T4 towers now. And they might be able to pull this one off. Palos, he's got so much damage. 20 seconds without the PL. Can they do it in time? Halberd out. Dagon there from Moon, but it's not doing enough. The damage is just not there. 10 more seconds. But that Ancient, it's going to fall very, very quickly here to Boom Esports as they're onto it now. 5 seconds left, Moon. He'll jump in. Mid one, he's just about to respawn, but the Ancient is just completely surrounded, and they'll take game two. A 2-0 lead now for Boom Esports in this best of five grand final. And what a game two it was.
I'd say Boom. I think Boom's lineup is really good for the Phantom Lancer. It has a lot of room to just do it at once. They're controlling the lanes a lot better, and they should be able to hit their power spikes a bit quicker.
ZTM, that early Centaur out, trying to apply the pressure onto KP. Won't bother even throwing out the stun, as Zarfu, he actually gets the kill.
Boom playing a slower game. I think they're playing a much more measured game. They just want to hit these farming spikes, want to hit the leveled spikes first. Not really force the issue out all too early on.
Nice little gank there though from FBZ onto FBZ from Rogi, and mid one is Moon. Mid lane, he's been caught out. Again, CTM is almost level 9 now. And with a Glimmer Cape up already. And the Fluffy Hat as well. He is a very, very tanky boy. The Rupture up Yapash instead. He's tanking through it as well. Glimmer Cape's there. It's not going to help too much. They should at least find KP though, but no. Yapash is down. And now CTM. Maybe this time they can take him out. And they will. In fact, Tim's, he joins the fray. They had the sentry down, but they won't have the follow-up dust.
SMG is smoking into him.
Yeah, I mean, Palos, he's been struggling. The defusal blade, not going to help him out if he does get disrupted. Is Moon going to jump in? Palos, they'll find the real target. Boundless strike there. Mid one should have enough and does. Counter smoke out. Line being drawn through that radiant jungle. Into the mid lane. Moon would be a great target if they can find it. There's your lasso out. Rogi, he wasn't ready for it. The aphonic shield's not there in time, and Moon's gone. Rupture is going to be used up on Tim's. Mortimer's Kisses as well expended here from Yopash to try and protect his teammate. But eventually Tim's is going to die. A 1-for-1. Certainly in the favor of Boom Esports, at least for now. But SMG looking for more, or maybe it's the other way around as KP gets jumped. And now mid one onto Yopash with the jump away with the cookie mid one. He's losing a lot of HP. Palos is going to back out. It's FBZ now. being targeted here by a Monkey King. Boundless strike out. They might have the damage, but no, he outruns the monkey. They can't kill him off. They're falling one by one here, SMG. They're going to drop. It's a full team wipe. The tips out from CTM.
Control just constantly weave in and out. They can really start reeling this game back more.
CTM, he's baiting in the mid lane, I think. He'll die in the mid, but look who they're going to catch out the top lane. It's all a distraction play here from CTM, and he's not even dead.
They have limited burst options to punish an inch, and that's just where all the value is coming. They do catch FBZ out, though.
Yeah, nice catch from KB. Purge is going to be there. They just really want to make sure they get this kill. FBZ, he's not even moving. He knows he's dead. Because he was ruptured up, so he can't really move, but bot lane, mid one. They may have seen him jump through that tree line. Primal Spring in. Again, CTM probably is not the target you want to start with, but he's the only target they can see right now. Mortimer's Kisses are going to start flying in onto Arfu. Zone him out on the Shadow Demon as mid one. He tries to get to work, but who are you going to aim? Nobody's within that Wukong's command. He'll keep jumping through now onto Tim's, but again, he's just being juke and jived around. Bloodrite's going to be there with the run of Atos. Cookie trying to help, but Tim's, he'll just run his own way out. As now Palos, he'll make his way back in onto KP, but again, he's just kiting in and out right now as the Impale is there, but mid one, he's still safe into the tree line. They are surrounded. They've got Palos. SMG, they do eventually get it done as they'll even find Tim's. Have they found a third? Well, CTM, of course, he's still around the area. And eventually, they'll get him. FBZ, he tried to help out. In fact, mid one, he wants more. Onto Yopash he goes, but the cookie up to the high ground. No, the tree cut. Gonna stun him up through the BKB. Mid lane, Tim's. In position. In fact, there's your lasso, but immediately the disruption's out. Roji, Moon, BKB out. Nice boundless strike as well. Mid one, he locks down two. Run of Atos is there. They should have a second in the form of Tim's, and eventually they'll get it. Another nice couple pickups here to get this team fight started as Yopash. He doesn't have a way to run out. He's been ruptured. He might get KB, but it is going to cost him his own life.
Yopash is still shoving in bot, although he will TP back. We want to defend him.
Lasso out. The four staff's there, but disruption. Arfu. Ready with it. Still, Impel is out. Mid one, he gets the aphotic shield now, and they do take down FBZ. KP has also dropped though, mind you, and there goes your Aegis. Mid one, he's very deep right now. He needs some help. BKB out. He'll pop the Wukong's command, and he'll go right for the TP. That's all he can do at the moment. Though I can't say the same for Moon, who did get caught up by Tim's. A bit entertaining now with the Snapfire. Though I say when it's 25 is the most entertaining because you get the three times the little shredder. Still top lane, FBZ been caught out with the purge out. He can't force staff away, and even Tim's drops mid lane. In fact, who else is that? It's CTM being chased down by Moon and Roji. But they'll have to let him go. It's top. They even found Palos. Another great kill here for SMG. They're going to lose KB out, but they've already found three different heroes. And now with that, they should be able to secure this tier 3 tower. They'll try to keep him healthy. Give him a reset to go back in. Boundless strike out. He'll go in onto CTM, but he's got the heal available. Yopash, he'll move in. Roji, you've got to be careful, but he does have that borrowed time. And now the Desolator hits Moon. He is just annihilating Yopash in that Snapfire. Eventually back in onto that top racks. And they should be able to claim it. No problem. Now it's all about just trying to get yourself out. In fact, never mind. Why not just go back in? They've got Tim's down, and they've got CTM, I think. That Glimmer Cape surely does... No, it does save him. Boundless off the mark. FBZ. Looking to move back in, but can he get a nice lasso off? Not quite. So one lane of barracks down. Do they want to keep playing with fire here, SMG? Boom. Now starting to move in that mid lane. Ping's immediately out on Palos as KP was looking for a rupture. Doesn't quite get it, but they've got the purge on FBZ. Gleipnir out as well into the boundless strike, and that'll be enough. However, Impel Moon, he'll BKB up and be just fine. Wukong's command is there. They're surrounding Tim's, and they've even got the Nyx Assassin. Another great pickup as KP. He will rush forward for the rupture out, and he's got the real Palos. That's the target you want. but can they deal with him? Gleipnir there, illusions, they are falling. Mid one, trying to chase him down. Palos still trying to be as elusive as possible. He'll rush forward onto Yopage. KP about to drop it, the balance is there. They've locked down Palos. Surely they get the kill, and they do. There is a buyback available.
So, gonna have to just force higher ground. Buyback is probably gonna have to be forced out here.
CTM, he's gonna survive with the Glimmer Cape. Timbs will try to drag this out with the Aghanim Scepter, but he's already taken so much damage from Moon and Mid One. They're just going right to work. Cookie's there, but it's not gonna be enough. He's down already. CTM, just with the impetus alone, is trying to hold them all back.
Huge margin. 4K at 36 minutes is not the biggest lead. It's still something you can play with.
Oh, that thought actually. Mid One gonna jump in. He is kind of alone right now, but his team is making his way over. And FBC's gone again. Just such a hard game for the Batrider, as now Timbs has also been caught out. And that's going to make this high ground defense very difficult. Glyph forced out, but it is still a 5v3. Mortimer's Kisses. He will spend it straight off the bat. It's not going to do too much, though. Just trying to zone them out and buy more time for the rest of the team to be up. But SMG, they're not going to back. They'll secure at least one lane of barracks before Timbs and FBZ are back up. Another nice objective secure here.
Check out Roshan as well. They've got the Heart and Palos. That stat stacking in the PL is up and running.
Palos. Move in, mid one, immediately out with the stun. Timbs is going to be there with the impel. Turn around, he's low on mana right now. Mid one is still going to go right after Timbs. They just burst him down so quick. Moon, he's got so much damage with the Leap Desolator. CTM. Slow it up, but there's your lasso out. They've got the target. Disruption is going to be there in time. Arfu, he may have saved the day, or maybe not, because the flame break is there. But mid one, again with the BKB, is going to be fine. Instead, they'll focus down Moon on the Morana, and they might just get him. Moon's down. No buyback for him, nor is there one for Arfu. And now Roji's gone. Though he does have a buyback. But they did not secure Roshan. Smoke out there from SMG, but it is a smoke on smoke situation between these two.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
TP in, Palos, that's a very confident TP. Arrow's not going to connect, mid one, still going to go for the man fight with the Wukong's command out. Palos, who is he going after? He'll try after KP, but he's taking so much damage. But now the lasso, they've got mid one, nothing to cancel that off. FBZ, he might eventually drop. He tries for the TP, but won't make it out. Still, Timbs back in with mid one, getting so much damage on. Wukong's command and the boundless strike does land on the PL. Nobody's actually dying yet, apart from Timbs. And FBZ, who bought back. Arfu, he will eventually drop.
Mid one,
he's very deep right now. Gonna be alright, just trying to sneak his way in with the Moonlight Shadow. Cookie, Yopage, this could be a bad, bad time as mid one has caught him, but FBZ, he's there with the lasso. Yopage, he got ruptured up, but he's gonna try and tip in. The bash comes out. KP's got him. He'll buy back on the Snapfire. Mid one, he may have gone too deep here, John. He's gonna Satanic soon, I hope. So the BKB has been popped. He does go for the life still, but Satanic is still there. He doesn't even need it. Timbs, he's down without buyback on that Nyx Assassin. And mid one, and Palos is gonna try and man fight here. Mortimer's Kiss is flying in. Mid one, he's out of mana. He's out of monkeys, and he is gonna go down. Eventually, the man fight pays off for the PL as FBZ still chasing down KP on the Bloodseeker. The Basher forcing the buyback out from Yopage as they will eventually come back to get Roji. That'll be gone, Palos. He'll keep moving forward. He wants the full racks taken. In fact, they could try and force a team fight here if they're feeling really cheeky. But mid one's going to be up in four. They are still going to be lacking Roji. But it might be enough for Boom Esports to pay respect to SMG and back out. And it looks like Boom Esports, they're going to disengage and find a better way into this fight. But it's an immediate smoke up and a rush forward here from SMG onto CTM. And that's a great boundless strike. It crits as well. Timbs is in trouble. They're both going to drop on the supports. It's now Palos. He's a sitting duck and he's gone.
And the control. And SMG realizes it's a big opening, which is going to for tier 4s.
Yeah. I mean, you've got to force the buybacks. In a game like this, so much on the line here between these two teams. Moonlight Shadow out, they're gonna try and force these T4s no matter what. Flame Break is there. Mid one. Immediate Wukong's command out. That area denial around the Roshan pit as the cliff is going to be forced. But Lasso is there. There's nothing to cancel Lasso off. They've got the Mortimer's Kisses flying as well. He needs to pop that Satanic. Mid one. He'll get into the fountain and he'll get rid of FBZ. Three down already. Boom Esports not looking great here. They'll find Rogi. Meanwhile, Yapash trying to find mid one in the tree line, but is unable to scout him out.
Look for the safe play. Look for the Megas first and completely shut this game out. Quickly, KB coming through.
Oh, Palos, he got scouted. The arrow's going to connect. He's gone. Or is he? Doppel's there in time, but it doesn't matter. Oh, the sentry ward was there. He thought he was invis. This game could just be over as Yapash goes down. SMG, they will win game three, and this grand final will continue.
The usual build-up is Echo Saber Desolator, and that's a much quicker build-up than the Monkey, and he should be online fast.
Well, AB, chant it up. Start moving in. Stroke of Fate's going to be decent, but with the poison attack damage out from Yopage and the slow added on top, should be first blood going to the Viper, and they will, of course, allow Yopage to take the kill.
So they're just lacking a recipe now, and at least when the Chen's out of position, they can bully out mid one.
Yeah, they're doing a great job of it. Ensnare up mid. Well, that's a great mischief dodge, but not enough.
It is a strong hero. It's not the flashiest, nor does it have the best control.
Group up mid lane. They're going to try and go after this Viper. There's no Aether Remnant to set up here, but it won't matter because they have the Inkswell. And it's a big commitment from SMG. Hot lane, Tims. Going to try and escape from KB in mid one, but they've got plenty of control here for Tims. Nice body blocks there from KB as Yopage and CTM are going to move in, but it won't make a difference. In fact, Moon, he's going to make the jump in on the Viper. It's a very, very big target. Simulated out, back the other way. Roar from FBZ to try and hold them back, but they've got the stuns there, and they've got the Wukong's command out. Cyclone onto Yopage. Can they hold him down? They won't even need to. Boundless Strike will be enough from mid one.
They do have a roll ready, but it's just Tim's ready to go.
We go, Rolling Thunder is there, does connect onto two, and they keep it up though. Moon, he actually kills off Palos in the triangle while all this is happening. He just snipes the Luna, and now they've lost CTM. After Tim's they go, the Rolling Thunder did nothing, and now it should be a pretty big cleanup for SMG, as they've got Tim's controlled up, mid one's in, and that'll be another kill out for Moon. So much pressure being applied here onto Boom Esports, as now SMG gonna move in, and they found Palos again. They have got the Luna, and she has not got any hop around us. Jesus, that was a deafening hand of God flying out. You kind of ignore the net worth lead, and you realize that Palos, he can't join the fights yet on that Luna. So it's really a 4v5. That does give the advantage to SMG. In fact, they found Palos. That's the target you'd love to start with, and Palos is gone. CTM will follow right afterwards. That's just terrible news here for Boom. Give you a bit of vision. That Roshan pit, Tim's just waiting for that right moment. They've got to know he's looking for a roll in, as there you go, Rolling Thunder is there. A little bit early, and he gets stuck. Oh, he gets stuck.
What?
How does that work? How is he stuck there? They just left him. They went right in for Yopage in the back lines. Yopage is going to drop, and Tim's gets zero value out of the Rolling Thunder. Roar is out though, they've got Moon. With the Eclipse out, they will at least clean up the Void Spirit, and they might even find KB, but mid one, he's gonna keep trying to force the fight. With the Aegis up, he's feeling confident. Buybacks there from Moon, onto CTM they go. They've already gotten Palos down, and they should have Tims, and they do, Moon. He'll rejoin the fight. Well, they still get Moon, and now mid one's joined in, and he wants to go right after that Viper, but a nice tree cut. Gonna make sure the Wukong's never flies out. Tim's is gonna be from the backside onto Arfu. They might get the Grimstroke again, but Yopage, he has still been caught out. They still get him in the end. Rogi will drop on the Chen. Palos is gonna pop the BKB, but can he actually man fight this Monkey King? Well, mid one, he's gonna back. KB will be left behind. In the end, well, they'll get the Brewmaster. Mid one, he's the only survivor.
Too long as well for Boom to get that Moon push and to equalize the lanes. It's actually bigger for Boom as they can take control of Rosh, but they will TP in for the tier 3s.
But they will. Nice Rolling Thunder to initiate. Mid one, he might get Permastunned. That's Soulbind is not going to help out. The floor is there. They've got him. Oh, the Soulbind worked against them. Mid one gets tipped immediately by CTM. Rogi's going to be able to get out. Oh, but the Soulbind, it doesn't work in their favor as now Tim's. He may have gone too far in the Pango. It does eventually drop, but can they find Moon? He's out of step charges. He's only got the Dissimilate. He'll try for the TP out. Is he gonna make it? He will.
With early Ags from Afu, Dark Portrait up, they can just get their own Luna off.
Halos, he's gonna BKB pop the Eclipse. He might just have to TP out, and he will commit eventually. Rest of the team is making their way over, but SMG, they're ready for this. They're gonna sneak up from the backside. Mid one, actually gets stunned by the Hawk there, but it won't matter too much. Viper Strike is out, but FBZ has been targeted once again, and he is gone immediately as mid one. He's dropping low himself. In fact, with this Rolling Thunder, they're gonna be able to finish him off, so it's not too bad of a trade so far for Boom Esports. They will move on to Afu, but Tims, he has been caught, and eventually will drop to KP. Roar out. It is on the Storm Panda. That's one, I guess it's one Brueling you're gonna get, but that's a Roar committed for that. Can they get the rest of them? Onto Afu they go. They'll get the Grimstroke down. Moon gonna step in after Palos. He's gonna force up to the high ground, but Moon, he's got the control and damage to take care of it. And Yopage now, he's taken so much damage from that Dark Portrait. That Lunar Illusion is really starting to get through him, and they get him. Moon able to take a double kill as now CTM, he's been left behind. He'll get a cheeky Fey Grenade out, but it's not going to do enough.
The high ground's opened up. SMG, they're just going to go for it.
We go, Balanced Strike, they've got the Viper. You'd love to get that target down. Yopage, he'll be forced to BKB and forced half out. They won't quite finish him off. Meanwhile, Tims. Soulbind's there, but it's not going to lock him down. Just trying to secure Afu, but a great Boundless Strike again from mid one. In he goes, onto the Pango and onto CTM. Just blows both of them up. Palos, he's going to try and run, but even with the BKB, he's just taking too much damage.
They've got Aegis still running for 2.5 minutes. And boom. It again just boils down to the fact that, in my view, it's FBZ.
They're gonna have to try, but Primal Spling is in mid one. Wants to go for the man fight immediately onto Palos. Wukong's command is gonna fly out. Palos, he'll be able to escape with the BKB, but in FBZ, he's already gone down. Moon just picks him off in the Void Spirit. They might be able to trade here as Yopage is stacking up the poison damage. Simulate is gonna be there. Moon, he's gonna survive. Just to rub salt into the wound of Boom Esports. As he comes back in for Tims now. Mid one, he'll just finish off the final lane of barracks. Megas are incoming. There's mid one, he's not done yet. He wants the Viper, he wants the Tims. They'll get the Aegis down, but they're gonna lose their Pango, and that'll be a dieback as Moon is back in, onto the Viper. Cyclone up, Yopage, he'll make it back to the fountain, but it's not looking great for Boom Esports. How do you defend?
They don't need to actually face these heroes. They know they can just melt the objectives, and they got the Dark Portrait again.
Oh, Palos, he's gone. No buyback. That's GG. SMG, they're on their way to a reverse sweep here, John, in this best of five grand final. From a 2-0 deficit against Boom Esports, suddenly it's a 2-2. And I'll tell you what, John, they might just be able to pull this one off.
I would prefer Boom here, but there is a mid-game timing where SMG is stronger. Not enough to offset how slow Palos to start is. Still, he's going to hit level 6 at a good point, and he can play from there.
Palos, he might be going down, and he does. Afu is able to secure the kill, but in the meantime, mid one drops down to the bot lane. So both position ones ends up dying. Because now Rogi does get caught out. A very nice spear there from FBZ. And Tims will jump in with the Primal Spring to make sure they secure the kill. SMG will try and do the exact same thing at the top lane. They'll make the jump in again onto Palos. But this time, Yopage, he'll make the rotation over in that tree line, but Moon's here as well. Doom is gonna fly out. They've got the Morph Link, but the Strength Morph is gonna be there in time, but it's probably not gonna matter, as it seems they might have enough damage in the end, and they do. KP able to clean up the kill and just make his way out, as Afu is still being chased down here and may eventually drop to Yopage. Top lane, Moon gonna turn back around onto CTM, trying to secure another kill. But there are too many heroes around. In fact, FBZ now does drop the arena, but he has no mana for the spear. And they will continue to chase him down with KP. Tims will hold back the Bloodseeker. going immediately. However, top lane, KP again going to be caught out. Gets the blood right and the rupture, but the chains don't land. So Yopage, he might have to go for a bit of a chase, but mid one's around as well. Spear though, FBZ actually catches mid one into the arrow.
What?
Oh, the save your buddy syndrome. It strikes again. Is KP, he's going to be caught out anyway. Doom's going to be there, but they have the arena out. FBZ, he never had to commit it. Moon, he's in pretty big danger right now. CTM though, no, he's going to miss the arrow.
Bit, but rupture there. Maj just forced a whale though.
Well, they got Moon, mid lane. Arrow actually is whiffed. Oh, the arrow does not land. And Moon, he will just keep pump faking the slammers now. Maybe they can finish him, but no, he's out. Yopage, he comes in from the backside and cleans him up, and now the double chains out into the Echo Slam. Afu, he's trying to help out. It won't matter.
Boom, are smoked up. You know, something's happening by Roshan.
You know, Roji, Gucci away. Chains are there on Moon. Arena Spear immediately into the arrow. Moon's gone. Yeah, Moon, he might need a BKB very, very soon, as this is proving to be a real issue. FBZ and CTM just constantly holding him down. Roji at least will be able to make the escape on the Weaver. In top lane, it may not be over. SMG, they might need to run. Tims, he's in. Echo committed from Afu onto one hero, but mid one, he's still going to be chained up. Arrows off the mark. It may not matter though. He'll try to fight the best he possibly can because he's got no exit plan whatsoever. He'll just chase down Tims, but he won't even get that. And KP, he might be targeted next to the spear. Going to be off the mark, but the Boundless Strike is out.
Matt, you can't even find the angle to lock in that Ember Spirit. And to make matters worse, he's got his axe out.
Mid one, to try and move in onto CTM. Yopage is around to protect his teammate, and now FBZ's in, but he missed the spear. He's popped the BKB. He'll commit to the team fight. Roji, he's kind of trapped up right now. Meanwhile, on the backside, mid one, he's trying to get his escape plan going, but it's not going to work out. Palos gets the kill. Everyone just wants the 3-2-2 to happen every time. As Moon's gonna jump in and try to ruin it, but no. Remnant's away. Stun's out. They've got Palos, but they can't do him up. They need that link. It's broken. Now mid one. He's been caught again with the spear out. FBZ. He will there not allow him. And there it is. The 3-2-2 is available. It's up. KP. Boundless is there. Arrow gonna connect. They've got more lockdown. Arfu's gone. He'll buy back. I have Skadi now up on the morph. He's much tankier and much harder to deal with as KP's too close. He is too close. Palos will get a double. At least on mid one. So he can't really afford to die at the moment. So they'll break the Lincolns, but Palos is going to get out scot-free. Moon, he's going to jump in. BKB up, but he does not want to commit onto Tims. Palos, he'll move in again. There's Yakko Slam Afu. He'll get rid of the Aegis and he gets rid of Tims. That's a start, but FBZ, he's going to jump in, spear off the mark. It won't matter though, because Arfu's down, and now Roji's just trapped up. He will drop as well. Doom is committed onto Yopage, but is it too late? It does seem like it. They'll try and move in. Mid one, he'll try onto Palos, but he's got the Weaver form now. He's got the Sakuchi up in mid one. He's a sitting duck. He'll try to run, but he cannot. No buyback. It's Palos. He's dropping low, but he's just not low enough, Moon. He's gonna drop. No buyback available.
Without the spells up, it's down to Boom to actually
get
them
down.
Moving.
FBZ, another great setup into the arrow. They've got him. That might be it. Another arena out. FBZ, he's just all over. He's got the refresh orb. GG. That's it, Boom Esports. After so many attempts, they have finally managed to pull it off here, John. If they just keep going forward into the fountain. But there you go. A 3-2 victory here for Boom Esports in the BTS Pro Series Season 8.